Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing both an initial value problem today and a trigonometric substitution problem today. It's going to be initial value problem example 8 and trigonometric substitution example 7. Both concepts are illustrated in this example. And the problem that we're going to be doing is dy over dt equals 1 divided by 25 plus 9t squared. And then we're also given this initial condition here, y of 5/3 equals pi over 30. So the first thing that we're going to do with this problem is go ahead and lay out a bunch of formulas. Because this is a trigonometric substitution problem, we have this identity here, a squared plus u squared, and then x equals a tangent of theta, and the identity 1 plus tangent squared of theta equals secant squared of theta. If you're having trouble or you're unfamiliar with either trigonometric substitution or initial value problems, you can look at both of those sections on my website for more information and more examples. But for now, I'm going to pretend you have a basic familiarity with both so that we can just move forward with this. So we can identify here that our trigonometric substitution identity is a squared plus u squared, because a represents the constant and u represents the variable here, and we have our constant plus our variable. So we have to identify the value of a and the value of u, which is going to be the square root of both of these terms. So a is going to be 5, because we take the square root of 25, and u is going to be 3t, because we take the square root of 9t squared, to get a equals 5 and u equals 3t. So given those two values, then we can plug them into our x equals a tangent of theta equation here. And we do so by plugging in u for x. So we have 3t and then plugging in 5 for a. So 3t equals 5 tangent of theta. And then we have this identity for later, because we're going to need it to make a substitution. So then we have a couple things to do before we can get started. We first need to solve this equation here for t. So we do that by dividing both sides by 3, and we get t equals 5/3 tangent of theta. Then we need to find the derivative of t, dt, by taking the derivative of this right-hand side over here, which we know is 5/3 secant squared of theta d theta is the derivative. So we have those two things. And then the last thing that we need to do is first solve for tangent of theta, which we pull from this equation here by dividing both sides by 5. So we get tangent of theta equals 3/5 3/5 t. And then we use that equation to solve for theta. We take the negative tangent, the inverse tangent of both sides, which makes this tangent over here on the right-hand side cancel, and we're left with theta equals tangent to the negative 1 of 3/5 t. So that's all of the prep work that we have to do when we have a trigonometric substitution problem, and now that we have all of those things laid out, we can go ahead and start actually solving the problem. So I've rewritten the problem down here without the initial condition, dy over dt, and then the first thing we're going to do is multiply both sides by dt and then integrate. So I've gone ahead and integrated both sides after I moved dt over to the right hand side here. Now for the integration. The left hand side, this integral of dy simply becomes y equals. The integral of dy is y, the integral of just dt alone would be t. So we're left with just y on the left hand side, and then the integral on the right-hand side, we have to tackle with trigonometric substitution. So the first thing that we do, you can see here in the original problem, we have t. Well, we solved for t up here. We got t equals 5/3 tangent of theta. So we plug that in for our t right here, and we have 5/3 tangent of theta. Don't forget to keep this squared sign here so that we don't lose it. It's very important. So we plug in for t, and then we also plug in for dt. Here, we solve for dt up in the formula section here. We got 5/3 secant squared of theta d theta. So we go ahead and plug that all in here. And once we've plugged in for t and dt, we can go ahead and start simplifying, substituting, all of those good things. So I just brought the problem over here onto this new page. So this is the previous step. Now we're going to go ahead and simplify. And the first thing I do is I bring this 5/3 out in front of the integral. It moves out here. And we can do that because everything inside the integral is multiplied together. So that 5/3 is like a coefficient on this entire term, and coefficients can be brought out in front. So we have this 5/3 out in front. And then the other thing I do is I move this secant squared of theta just up here to the numerator to simplify. And then the last thing I did in this step was I simplified this 9 times the 5/3 squared here. So 5/3 squared would be 25/9, right? So 25/9 times 9, the 9s would cancel and we'd be just left with 25. So I have that 25 here, and then notice that I also have tangent squared of theta because I have this squared sign here. So not only do we have to square the 5/3, we also have to square tangent of theta. So that simplifies to 25 tangent squared of theta. Then in the next step, I go ahead and factor the denominator because we're trying to get to a point where we can use our identity to solve from our identity from the formula section to solve here. So, so I go ahead and factor out the 25, and I'm left with 1 plus tangent squared of theta, which I should have kept that on the page, but from the previous page, our identity that we had originally, we said 1 plus tangent squared of theta was equal to secant squared of theta, which is part of our trigonometric substitution formula. So substituting, we have secant squared of theta here on the bottom. The 25 I pulled out in front, 5/3 times 25, or sorry, times 1 over 25 would be 1 over 15. So I simplify that coefficient and then make our substitution, and we're just left with secant squared of theta divided by secant squared of theta, which means that those two will cancel, and we'll just be left with 1/15 times the integral of d theta. That's the only thing left in our integral. So remember before when we took the integral of dy, it was y. I said if we took the integral of dt, it would be t. Well, in this case, taking the integral of d theta will simply give us theta. So we have 1/15 times theta. And then, of course, we add c as that constant of integration to account for a constant. So that's also going to be, that c is going to be what we need to use our initial condition from the original problem to solve for c. So next thing we do is, from the previous screen, we had solved for theta in our original formula section, and our answer for theta was tangent to the negative 1 of 3/5 t. So we plug in this whole thing here for theta, and then in the next step we'll go ahead and use our initial condition. So we plug that in, and then the next thing we do is we use our initial condition. So this is saying here that y of t equals some value. So when 5/3 is equal to t, y is equal to pi over 30. So we go ahead and plug in pi over 30 for y here, and then we go ahead and plug in 5/3 down here for t. And then we simplify that so that eventually we can solve for c. So first thing you're going to notice in the next step is that we have 3/5 times 5/3, so that's going to cancel and just give you 1 down here. So we have that 1. I'm going to move everything to the left side. I'm going to subtract this whole term here so I get c on its own because, again, we're trying to solve for c. And then I'm going to solve for c. So tangent to the negative 1 or the inverse tangent of 1 is pi over 4. So I go ahead and substitute that in, and then I'm going to simplify, and we get 1/15 times pi over 4 would, of course, be pi over 60. So solving there, I multiply the first term by 2 over 2, so that I can get a common denominator here of 60. So we get 2 pi over 60 minus pi over 60, which of course is pi over 60. So I've solved for C as pi over 60, and now what we're going to do is take this value and plug it in right here for our C, and that's going to be our final answer. So our final answer is this, one misstep here. This is supposed to be 1/15. There's supposed to be a 1 right here. 1/15, and then arctan is the same thing as the inverse tangent. It's a cleaner way of writing it instead of tangent to the negative 1, but they're equivalent. So arctan of 3/5 t, and then of course plus, instead of c, plus pi over 60 because we went ahead and solved for c. So through trigonometric substitution, that is how you solve this initial value problem. So hope that helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!